Hello, my name is Paul Bevan from Siemens Digital Industries Software, and in this brief demonstration, I'd like to take you through an enhancement to algorithmic modeling in the December 2023 release of NX. Now, you may well have seen a demonstration I did earlier on the year for the June 2023 release of NX, where we added the text on face node into algorithmic modeling. And we use this node to generate a dynamic display for the shower flow on the cover, as you can see in the graphics window. What I'm going to do in this demonstration is to use the new offset region node in algorithmic modeling to enhance the rule for the text for the shower flow display. And this means I'll be able to include the embossed text into the part within the rule, therefore speeding up the design process. So I'm going to start by isolating the shower cover front and then editing the definition of my algorithmic feature. So as I said earlier, this is the algorithmic rule that defines the dynamic display for the shower flow. And what I'm going to do next is to search for the new offset region node and include that in my rule. Now, before I start to connect the ports on the offset region node, I'm going to flatten the output list of curves that I've got from my text on face node. And the reason I'm doing that is that I get a single list, and that list includes both the inner and outer boundaries of the curves. So if you look at the number 8, for example, obviously you've got the outer boundary and then two inner boundaries. And NX then will be intelligent enough to know what is the inner and outer boundary when it creates the offset region. So I'll go ahead and connect the output node of the flattened list to the input node for the boundary curves for the offset region. I'll connect the face that the text lays on to the input node for the face on the offset region. And then I'm going to create an input for the offset distance itself. And after entering an input value, I can preview the offset. You can see it here in the graphics window. And I can control the direction of the offset by simply reversing it. Here, I use a true or false statement to do that. Finally, I create the output body for the offset region, and my modified rule is now complete. I can now exit the logic editor, but save the rule as I've modified it, and I'm back in the front cover. You can see the features in the part navigator. I'm just going to hide the original body. And now our algorithmic feature includes that offset region. If I just go ahead and hide the sketch, we can go back in and make an edit to the algorithmic feature. And I'm going to start by reversing the offset direction. It's very easy to do from within the user interface. I just toggle off the reverse offset direction, and you can see now that the offset is coming away from the model as opposed to being indented. If I go back into the feature and make further changes, I'm going to switch the reverse offset direction back on. However, this time I'm going to change the lowest and highest value from max and min to low and high, and also the range of numbers on the flow I'm going to change to 12. And you can see here how the flow display dynamically updates. If we go back into the assembly, again, you can see the changes that we made. So just to recap, we looked at an existing rule that was created to generate a dynamic shower flow display. We made a modification to that rule by incorporating the new offset region node. And then we were able to resave the rule, reapply the algorithmic feature, taking into consideration the new capabilities within the December 2023 release of NX. I'd like to thank you for your time and attention.